Hello friends, I am NKJN from Skill on Tech. In the series of top 200 pump interview questions, I am presenting some important questions, part 6 of 20, question 51 to 60. These questions will be very helpful to mechanical engineering students as well as to working engineers in the industries. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues. Question 51. You require high flow with moderate pressure. Which pump is suitable? You can see a picture of an axial flow pump. Axial flow pumps are more suitable for high discharge, high flow, and moderate pressure. It is a pump in which fluid flows axially to the rotation of the impeller. In axial flow, the fluid flows parallel to the axis of rotation as in a turbine. Axial flow pump contains a propeller or a centrifugal impeller in the casing. Axial flow pumps are found mainly in sewage treatment plants and agriculture irrigation. They are also used in fisheries, flood control operation, chemical industries, power plants, etc. Question 52. You require moderate flow with high pressure. Which pump is suitable? You can see some pictures. Radial flow and mixed flow centrifugal pumps are widely used for moderate flow and high pressure. The flow of mixed flow impellers are more compared to radial flow impellers. You can see in the pictures the specific speed of the pumps will decide the type of pump. For radial flow impellers, the specific speed is up to 70. For mixed flow impellers, the specific speed is up to 160. And for axial flow impellers, specific speed is from 140 to 400 revolution per minute. Which pump is used for slurry applications? Slurry pump is a type of pump designed for pumping liquid containing solid particles. Slurry pump changes in design and construction to adjust to multiple type of slurry which varies in concentration of solids, size of solid particles, shape of solid particles and composition of solution. Slurry pumps have added sacrificial material and replaceable wear parts to withstand wear due to abrasion. The most common type of slurry pump is the centrifugal pump and vertex pump. These pumps use a rotating impeller to move the slurry, similar to how a water-like liquid would move through a standard centrifugal pump. Any type of impeller can be used in slurry applications, but open impellers are more common because they are less likely to clog. Closed impellers usually don't do well with solids and are difficult to clean if they become clogged. Therefore, during clean water application, we use closed impellers, and in case of pure slurry, we use open impellers, and in case of little muddy water, then we may use semi-open impeller or semi-closed impeller. Which pump is used for toxic fluids? Centrifugal pump or reciprocating pumps equipped with mechanical seals are used as per application and design requirement for toxic fluids or precious fluids. Mechanical seal equipped pumps are recommended due to zero or less leakage through gland packing. Canned motor pumps are widely used for toxic and precious fluids. Canned motor pumps are widely used in nuclear industries to handle heavy water. For detailed knowledge, you can see our video on canned motor pump and mechanical seal. Your process fluid is very viscous. Which pump is suitable? Gear/lobe type metering pumps are used for viscous flow. Rotary lobe pump is ideal for liquid transfer of high viscosity fluid such as heavy oils, glycerin, chocolate, marmalade, etc. Positive displaced pumps are preferred. You can see a picture of peristaltic pumps progressive cavity pumps and high viscosity barrel pump. When backward vane impellers are preferred, you can see a picture. This is a HQ curve capacity and this is head. And if your shape of impeller is forward curved, then characteristics curve will be like this. Then if it is straight, then it will be like this. And if impellers is backward curved, then characteristics curve will go like this. So these are the three different characteristics curve with the different type of impeller. The straight blades impart an equal force out as rotational, while the backward curved blade reduce the rotational force on the fluid. Therefore, backward curved blades are the most efficient. A fan with backward curved vanes has to run at a higher speed than the other two type of fans, but its efficiency is much higher if properly designed. The maximum efficiency of a fan with backward curved vanes can reach 90%, while a radial vane fan reaches 80% and a fan with forward vanes about 70%. Centrifugal pumps are provided backward curved vanes. So you can see a picture of radial vanes, backward curved vanes and forward vanes here. When forward vane impellers are preferred, in backward curved vanes, fluid outlet flow at less than 90 degrees. Radial blade exit angle at 90 degree and in forward curved blade exit angle at more than 90 degree. The blade of compressors are either forward curved or radial, whereas modern compressors are used radial vanes. Forward curved vanes deliver high pressure but efficiencies are low. Forward curved vanes are not used in pumps as they deliver unstable performance. Hence, backward curved vanes are used in pumps. When straight vane impellers are preferred, where a large pressure rise is needed with a machine of a small size, radial blades are used though the efficiency may not be high. Radial fans are one of the important type of industrial fans to have received wide acceptance. These fans are used in factories, mines, and commercial buildings. You can see a picture here. This is a shutoff head and this is a discharge here. So these are the blade angles. Here you can see the beta 2 is greater than 90 forward curved vane. This is a neutral. Beta 2 is less than 90 degree falling, means backward curved vane. So, what is open, semi-open and closed impeller? You can see a picture of open impeller, semi-open impeller and a closed impeller. Open impellers have the vanes free on both sides. Open impellers are structurally weak. They are typically used in small diameter, inexpensive pumps and pumps handling suspended solids such as slurry applications. Semi-open impeller, the vane are free on one side and enclosed on the other. The shroud add mechanical strength. They also offer higher efficiencies than open impellers. They can be used in medium diameter pumps and with liquids containing a small amount of suspended solids. Because of the minimization of recirculation and other losses, it is very important that a small clearance exists between the impeller vane and the casing. Closed impellers, the vanes are located between the two discs, all in a single casing. They are used in large pumps with high efficiencies and low required. Here you can see a closed impeller. This is a shroud and this is another shroud. So, vanes are inside of this. What is the advantage of multi-stage pump over pump in series / parallel? Multi-stage pumps, a combination of various impellers mounted on single shaft. They deliver high pressure and constant flow. They are compact and require less space and operation is controlled by single switch. Whereas pump in series are also used to deliver higher pressure, but pumps are installed in a series where discharge of first pump becomes suction of second pump and so on. These pumps occupy more space in operation, is also with various switches and complications. Therefore, where we need high pressure requirements, multi-stage pumps are used compared to pumps in series. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.